I'm going to sing a song now by a poet, a Scots poet called Alan Ramsay. Alan Ramsay wrote this poem called The Lass of Patey's Mill. Any Scottish country dancers here? Any, no? Ah, well, I'm safe then to tell the story. Anyway, The Lass of Patey's Mill is a very popular Scottish country dance tune. This song uses the tune, but it's much slower. Anyway, it's called The Lass of Patey's Mill, and the story of this song is that Alan Ramsay was out walking with his friend, the Earl of Loudoun. Everybody should have a friend called the Earl of Loudoun. He's out walking with his friend, the Earl of Loudoun, and they come upon a peasant girl working away there, doing stuff, baling hay, feeding sheep, I don't know, some of that stuff. And they stop and admire this young woman in silent admiration. I suspect they were struck dumb by the sight of somebody working for a living, is probably what it was. Anyway, and the Earl of Loudoun says to Alan Ramsay, "I don't imagine that you could construct a poem on such a subject as this." And Alan Ramsay said, "You bet I can, your lordship." And he wrote this poem called The Lass of Patey's Mill. Now, the tune that it was set to is described as Italian in nature, whatever that means, right? But it's supposed to have been written by an Italian, a man called David Rizzio. And David Rizzio, in the 1500s, was Mary Queen of Scots' secretary and, rumour has it, supplier of certain personal services after dark. And he came to a nasty ending because her husband, Lord Darnley, came home unexpectedly. And I guess there wasn't a chimney to hide up or something. Anyway, that was the end of David Rizzio. So the tune is The Lass of Patey's Mill. Oh, the lass of Patey's Mill, say bonny blithe and gay, in spite of all my skill, I stole my heart away while treading on the hay, bareheaded on the green. But in her locks did play and wanton in the rain, without the help of art, as flowers that grace the wild, she did her sweets impart where'er she spoke or smiled. Her looks, they were so mild, a form affected pride. She has my heart beguiled, I wish her for my bride. Oh, if I had all the wealth, oh, towns high, mountains hill, then should good luck and health and pleasures at my will, I promise and fulfill that none but bonny she, the lass of Patey's Mill, shall bear the same way me. Oh, the lass of Patey's Mill, say bonny blithe and gay, in spite of all my skill, has stole my heart away, while treading on the hay, bareheaded on the green, love in her locks to play, and wanton in the